Oh, hey, it's George from Brandywine Valley Active Aging. Come on in. You know, at BVAA, we have a hashtag. It's Get Busy Living. And we partnered with our friends, the experts at Elite Therapy Solutions, to help us live our best life. Come on.
Subscribe to our Brandywine Valley Active Aging and Elite Therapy Solutions YouTube channels and stay up to date with new videos. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up.
As we age, our eyes will change, and our ability to see things will also change. In today's short video, I will be going over some common age-related eye changes and some tips and tricks on how to adapt your environment to be able to see and perform to the best of your ability.
Some common age-related eye changes. Presbyopia. After you pass the milestone age of about 40, you'll notice it becomes more difficult to focus on objects up close. This is because the lens inside the eye begins to lose its ability to change shape, a process called presbyopia. For a time, you can compensate for this gradual decline in focusing ability by holding reading material farther away from your eyes, but eventually you'll need reading glasses, progressive lenses, or multifocal contact lenses. Cataracts. Even though cataracts are considered an age-related eye disease, they are so common among seniors that they also may be classified as a normal aging change. According to the Mayo Clinic, about half of all 65-year-old Americans have some degree of cataract formation in their eyes. As you enter into your 70s, this percentage is even higher. Reduced pupil size. As we age, muscles that control our pupil size and reaction to light lose some strength. This causes the pupil to become smaller and less responsive to changes in ambient lighting. Because of these changes, people in their 60s need 3 times more ambient light for comfortable reading than those in their 20s. Also, seniors are more likely to be dazzled by bright sunlight and glare when emerging from a dimly lit building, such as a movie theater. Eyeglasses with photochromic lenses and anti-reflective coating can help reduce this problem. Dry eyes. As we age, our bodies produce fewer tears. This is particularly true for women after menopause. If you begin to experience a burning sensation, stinging, or other eye discomfort related to dry eyes, use artificial tears as needed throughout the day for comfort. Or, better yet, consult your eye doctor for other options such as a prescription dry eye medication. Here are some adaptations to help with vision at home. Add contrasting background. At times, it can be hard to see things when they are the same color as the counter in which they are placed on. In order to better see your objects, try adding a colorful placemat or a piece of colorful construction paper underneath to provide some contrasting color to better view items. Depth perception. As we age, our ability to judge depth, such as stairs, curbs, and thresholds, can become more difficult. To help your eyes see depth more clearly, add non-skid tape in a bright color to the edges of stairs, curbs, and thresholds to prevent tripping or improperly judging depth. Good lighting. One thing that I commonly see when I'm within a home is poor lighting. Make sure that when you are moving about and going upstairs in particular, you have adequate lighting to be able to ensure that you are seeing the stairs clearly. Additionally, if you enjoy reading, reduce eye strain by making sure you're reading with good light nearby. Yearly checkups. One of the best and most important things you can do for your eyes is to routinely get eye exams with your ophthalmologist. This can help you to determine how your eyes are changing and to help address concerns you're having before they get more serious.
As with any age-related change, your best course of action is going to be to talk to a professional, such as your ophthalmologist. If you or somebody you know thinks they have some vision problems and want to talk to an occupational therapist about some environmental adaptations, I'm happy to consult with you. Please call 610-594-2060 and I'll be sure to get back to you. Until next time, stay safe, stay healthy, and get busy living.
Thank you for tuning in to today's episode of Ask the Experts at Elite. brought to you by Brandywine Valley Active Aging. We'll see you next time.